Welcome to Medical Channel, where we bring you the latest medical research and information in an engaging and accessible way. Join us as we explore how to improve your health and quality of life together. Ear infections causes, symptoms, and treatment. Experiencing inner ear discomfort or constant pressure, pus drainage, or hearing loss may be symptoms of an ear infection. You can use over-the-counter OTC treatments or consult a doctor if your symptoms don't improve. Ear infections can be either bacterial or viral infections. They can occur in your middle ear, the part of your ear just behind your eardrum, as well as the outer and inner ear. They often clear up on their own but can be painful due to inflammation or fluid buildup. Ear infections can be chronic or acute. Acute ear infections are painful but short in duration. Chronic ear infections either don't clear up or recur many times. They can cause damage to the middle and inner ear, which is infrequently permanent. Keep reading to learn about ear infections, including causes, symptoms, and treatment options. What are the symptoms of ear infections? Common symptoms of ear infections include mild pain or discomfort inside your ear, a persistent feeling of pressure inside your ear, pus-like ear drainage, hearing loss. These symptoms might persist or come and go. Symptoms may occur in one or both ears. Pain is usually more severe with a double ear infection, which is an infection in both ears. Chronic ear infection symptoms may be less noticeable than those of acute ear infections. Symptoms of an ear infection in children. Along with symptoms seen in adults, such as ear pain and drainage, young children and babies may show other signs of an ear infection, such as rubbing or pulling their ear, fever, not reacting to certain sounds, frequently losing balance, headache, fussiness or restlessness, loss of appetite. Usually, ear infections last fewer than 3 days, but they can persist for up to a week. Children younger than 6 months who have a fever or other ear infection symptoms should see a doctor. Seek medical attention if your child has a fever higher than 102 degrees Fahrenheit, 39 degrees Celsius, or severe ear pain. What causes an ear infection and what increases your risk? Ear infections are caused by viruses or bacteria, particularly the bacteria Streptococcus pneumoniae trusted source or Haemophilus influenza. They often result from a blockage of your eustachian tubes, which causes fluid to build up in your middle ear. Eustachian tubes are small tubes that run from each of your ears directly to the back of your throat. Causes of eustachian tube blockage include allergies, colds, sinus infections, excess mucus, smoking, changes in air pressure. Ear infections can also develop from infected adenoids. Your adenoids are glands on the roof of your mouth behind your nose that help protect your body from infections. Infections can spread from these glands to the nearby ends of your eustachian tubes. Risk factors for ear infections. Ear infections occur most commonly in young children because they have short and narrow eustachian tubes. About 80% trusted source of children develop an acute ear infection at some point. Infants who are bottle-fed also have a higher incidence of ear infections than their breast-fed counterparts. Other factors that increase the risk of developing an ear infection are altitude changes, changes in temperature and humidity, exposure to cigarette smoke, pacifier use, recent illness or ear infection, being male, low birth weight, lack of access to health care, being in daycare. Potential complications of an ear infection. Ear infections usually clear up without intervention, but they may recur. These rare but serious complications may follow an ear infection: hearing loss, speech or language delay in children, which is more common when there is chronic fluid in the middle ear, mastoiditis, an infection of the mastoid bone in the skull, meningitis, a bacterial infection of the membranes covering the brain and spinal cord, Ruptured eardrum. How are ear infections treated? While most mild ear infections clear up without intervention, the following treatments can also help. Home treatment. These methods are effective in relieving the symptoms of a mild ear infection. Apply a warm cloth to the affected ear. Take over-the-counter OTC pain medication such as ibuprofen, Advil or acetaminophen, Tylenol. Use OTC or prescription ear drops to relieve pain. Take OTC decongestants like pseudoephedrine, Sudafed. Avoid sleeping on the affected ear. Medical treatment. If your symptoms get worse or don't improve, see a doctor. They may prescribe antibiotics if your ear infection is bacterial, chronic, or doesn't appear to be improving. Antibiotics don't help treat viral infections. Medical treatment in children. Doctors often take a wait-and-see approach when treating ear infections in children to avoid overprescribing antibiotics, which can lead to antibiotic resistance. A doctor may sometimes write you a prescription for antibiotics if symptoms are severe or don't resolve within 2 to 3 days. Alternatively, they may write you a prescription but recommend waiting first to see if your child's symptoms get better after 2 to 3 days. It's important to finish your entire prescription. Often, a 7 or 10 day trusted source prescription of amoxicillin is prescribed. You shouldn't give children aspirin without their doctor's instruction. Aspirin is a preventable risk factor for developing Reye's syndrome, a rare disorder that causes brain and liver damage. Surgery. Surgery may be an option if your ear infection isn't eliminated with the usual medical treatments or if you have many ear infections over a short period. Most often, ear tubes are placed in your ears to allow fluid to drain out. These tubes are surgically inserted into your eardrums. They eventually fall out and the holes heal over. Sometimes these holes need to be closed surgically. Note: if you have infections with tubes in place, symptoms will be drainage rather than pain, pressure, or fever. These ear infections can be treated with drops. A mirroring